Hello traders, welcome back to my channel. In this video I want to show you how to predict the next candlestick with candlestick psychology. So let's start. I'm going to place color frame here. So the major and minor trend is down, but I'm seeing that some rejections from buyers. The market also reversed here, and a bias entry from here, again a bullish candle. Means that from this level here is bias area, so you can expect a bullish candle because of this rejection. Okay,
you have 10 new WhatsApp messages.
We see there's a strong rejection from here. The sellers entered here, so sellers entered from this level, and again we are seeing some rejection. So I'm going to place put option now. I place put option here because we see
a new SMS from EXTRADATA.
Because we see very strong rejection from sellers and a strong sellers entry. Then again we see again rejection from sellers and a sellers entry. Now the buyers come up to this level. There was a strong push phase to the upside. Then we see rejection, and a weak candle. So we can expect the seller's entry from that level. That is why I place put option. Okay, I'm not advising every one of you to trade on every candlestick. So don't trade on every candlestick. Wait for the right moment and place your trade. Trading on every candlestick means you are familiar with the candlestick, and we are familiar with the market structure, market situation, everything about the market. So that is the reason why I'm trading on every candlestick, and I want to let you know different kind of market situation. That is why I'm trading on every candlestick. So if you see me placing trade on every candlestick, means I want to let you know different market situation. So the analysis I did here is different from this, and also is different from this. So the reason why I place put option here, because we see the market is reversing from this level. Then previously we see there was a level here, the buyers paid to break this level for a very long period of time. Then we see the market also come back to that same level and retest it. So this is a reversal candlestick. So after this candle, buyers should now enter now. But I know that there's going to be one bearish candle for the buyers to enter, but there's no rejection. Okay, buyer will still enter on the next candle. So let's choose next pair. Okay, so don't trade on every candlestick. Trade on a certain pair. If you take one trade on one pair, wait for the next like 20 to 30 minutes before you take another trade. Okay, so don't trade on every candlestick. Here the market is consolidating, a build up. You see the trend was in a downtrend, then buyers find a push phase to the upside. The market now is in a consolidation level, consolidation area. Going to place call option because this is looking like a reversal candlestick. You already know this candlestick, a reversal candlestick, inverted hammer at the bias area, so we can expect a bias entry from this level. That is why I place call option. So not advisable to be trading on every candlestick. If you take one trade here, wait for like 20 to 30 minutes before you take another trade, because, and again, you should get ready for loss. Loss are very common in trading. At the last second, buyers entered, but the weak buyers. Okay, I'll place my trade. If buyers come down very, there was a strong rejection, I'll place call. I'm going to place call option from here. I think it should now go up. Oh shit. The reason why I place call option, because if you observe this candle, the momentum, sellers lose the momentum. The momentum of sellers reduce when they reach this level. You can see the weak candle. You can see they start reducing. You can see very strong rejection, buyers try to go up, then strong rejection from sellers, again a seller's entry but a weak seller. So we can expect a bullish candle on the next candle after this weak candle, but it seems the my entry is very late here, so I may lose this trade. Okay, buyers did not enter. Don't know why buyers do not enter. You can see buyers try to enter but still fail. This is somewhat confusing. We can do but did not reverse. Again, buyers try to enter but fail. They try here, fail. Try here, fail. They try here, also fail. Now they try very strongly. Okay. So I'll wait for the next candle. It's better to wait. So what am I saying is, you should not trade on every candlestick. Trade on a certain pair, wait for like 20 to 30 minutes before you place your trade. There was a rejection from sellers here. We can expect sellers entry if this candle will close above this line. Not close above the line, going to place call option. I place call option because it did not close above the line, but though there's always a rejection, but it did not close above the line. So we can expect the buyer's entry again from this level. One more trade. Okay, I think only 5 pairs available. So that means I'll take one more trade here. So if this candle will close here, I'll go with sellers. So let's see where next candle will open. Okay. ATM, going to place call option again. ATM. Okay, ATM. Buyers will still enter again because I want the candle to close above this line. So once the candle close above this line, you can expect sellers entry. So now the candle now is above the line. So it means that even though we see a strong candle, but there's a strong rejection as well, we can go with sellers on the next candle. Okay. Now we can see rejections, means that the sellers are there.
You have 12 people.
One of these put option, you can expect sellers entry now. Because according to my setup, according to the analysis here, I said if buyers will cross this level, sellers will enter. Now they finally cross the level, so we can expect the seller's entry from this level. Okay. So right now I took how many trades? This is total 7 trades. One is OTM because of my mistake. I think the OTM was somewhere here. Because of my mistake, I don't know why sellers still entered. Okay, finally buyers entered. I think that is why I lost the trade. So if you want to trade successfully in binary option, don't trade on every candlestick. Trade like a sniper. A sniper doesn't shoot sporadically, they shoot once. So trade like a sniper, and I'll stop the trading for today. Okay guys, if you like my video, like, share and subscribe.